Alright, so I am setting up a new, a brand spanking new, OS. It's a Linux machine. And it's Debian. Exactly 15 gigs. I'm going to do 100 gigs for the hard drive space. And that's gonna take a while. Simpsons, 5 minutes remaining. Alright, so now that it's created, let's do video memory as 48 megs. Don't want to overdo it, but don't want it too low either. And so, to add the, OS. All right, so to add the actual OS, select the box that you're wanting to add the ISO file to and click settings. This box should show up. Come down here to storage. And under controller IDE, click on the empty and then come over here and click on this CD and choose slash create a virtual optical disk. And add. Alright, so I am gonna start over to allow you guys to see every step in its glorious detail. Settings down here. All right, so settings, storage, select empty. Okay, so in order to attach the ISO file of whatever OS you're wanting to attach to this, you select whichever operating system you want from the side panel. Don't double click, it has to be single click, and it has to be a left click. Click on settings, and this window pops up. And on the left here, click on storage. And under controller IDE, click on empty. And this comes up, the attributes and information for the whichever controller you have. And click on the CD over here and click on choose create a virtual optical disk. At this point, this window pops up. Click on add. And then, find the, should be under documents, OS. In this one, I want it to be Kali Linux 2019.4. And then choose. I'm going to click OK and start. Not much, how you doing? Pretty good. Yeah, just running a little, setting up the Kali Linux. Because, you know, wanting to learn stuff. Okay. United States, American English. And, of course, when you're setting this up, do it with the specs that you need or would prefer. Oh, that sounds like a whole lot of fun. I have yet to do that for my router. I should probably do that pretty soon. I am in the Pacific time zone. Partition scheme, all files in one partition. And then finish partitioning and write changes to disk. And then write the changes to disks. And we click OK. And start. Not much, how you doing? Pretty good. Just running a little, setting up the Kali Linux. Because, wanting to learn stuff. Okay. United States, American English. And, of course, when you're setting this up, do it with the specs that you need or would prefer. Oh, that sounds like a whole lot of fun. I have yet to do that for my router. I should probably do that pretty soon. I am in the Pacific time zone. Partitions in all files in one partition. Then finish partitioning and write changes to disk. And then write the changes to disks. And I do want to specify this is for educational purposes only. Do not use this to go all black hat on us. Copying data to disk. That's going to take a while. And while this. While this is going on, let's see. And so back over here to the machine. A network mirror can be used to supplement the software that is included on the installation media. This may also make newer versions of software available. Do you want to use a network mirror? Alright, so while this is finishing up, I am going to be right back in just a moment. Alright, so.